back, my dear children. I hope you all are doing fine. Today our topic is water, and from this topic we will learn three different points. The first is uses of water, second sources of water, the third one is water that gets into our homes. Before we go to the topic, let us first try to solve the question that is given on the board. The question here, it says, circle the things that need water to live. Do the table need water to live? No. Tiger? Yes. Rose? Yes. Man? Yes. Television? No. Frog? Yes. Fish? Yes. Tree? Yes. Book? No, because book is a non-living thing. So why did we circle this? We have circled this because they are all living things and they need water to live. They cannot live without water. The first topic is uses of water. As we all know, water is a basic need. So we use water in many ways. We use water for drinking, cooking, washing dishes, watering the plants, cleaning our dishes, and for many other purposes. The next is sources of water. Rain is the main source of water. So this rainwater, it gets collected in river, lakes, ponds, wells, tanks. So this is how we get the water. This river, lakes, tanks and ponds, these are all called the sources of water. The next is how water gets into our homes. We don't use the rainwater as it is. It is first cleaned and then the clean water gets pumped in the overhead tank, and after it is pumped to an overhead tank, it gets to our homes through the pipelines. And how does it get? How do we get this water inside our homes? We get it from the taps that are fitted inside our homes. Some they get it from the hand pumps and wells. The next is drinking water. It is not safe to drink dirty water, because there are germs present in the water which may make us fall sick. So we should purify the water before drinking. We can purify the water in two ways, that is boiling and filtering. Boiling, it kills the germs that is present in the water. Whereas by filtering removes the germs from the water. And when you are storing the water, you should always store the water in clean container, and your water should always be covered. Now let us try to do one activity as we have learned in the third topic, that is how water gets to our homes. Here we'll have to number the steps in correct order. Let us see. The first step is the rainwater is clean. So what is the first step? How do water gets into our homes? The first one is the rainwater gets collected in river. This is the first step. The second step is the rainwater is clean. After it gets collected in rivers, it is first the rainwater is clean. And the third step will be the water is pumped to an overhead tank. This is the third step. The last one is the water from the overhead tank reaches our homes. So this is how rainwater gets into our homes. Based on this topic, I would like everyone to do activity one, that is in page number 16. This is all for today. Thank you and have a great day ahead.